Hello friends, welcome to my channel Tutor. The topic that we are going to do today is liquid pressure. So liquid pressure, as the name suggests, is the pressure because of a liquid. Now the liquid particles, they apply some pressure, and this pressure constitutes to liquid pressure. Let's quickly see a simulation by Fate Colorado related to liquid pressure, which will explain you the concept in a much better way. On my screen, you can see the simulation by Fate Colorado. Now in this, I have a tank and it is filled with water. So what I'll do is I'll put in some more water and I'll put a grid. So this grid tells me what are the, you know, different dimensions, like the water at height 1 meter, at depth 2 meter and at depth 3 meter. What I'll do is I'll put this measuring device inside my water. Now, when a measuring device is used to measure the liquid pressure, it is known as it is a manometer that is used. And to measure the pressure in the air, that is atmospheric pressure, a barometer is used. So this manometer has been placed at, let's say, level 1. So, yes, roundabout, this is almost fine. I'll put another one at the same level, that is 1 meter, and check out the readings. So the readings on the manometer is same, that is 108.390 kilopascal. So I can say that liquid pressure at a certain height at the same level, it is same. So I'll do what? I'll put this down a little bit. So this is at 2 meter and this is at a depth of 3 meter. Now closely look, what is the reading at 1 meter? It is 108.390 kilopascal, right? At 2 meter, it is 118.148 kilopascal. And at level, like at 3 meter depth, it is 127.817 kilopascal. So what does this say about my pressure with the increase in depth? As I can see that the reading on the manometer, it is increasing as we are going down. So as a depth increases, the pressure, it will keep on increasing, right? So now we have concluded two things. One, at a certain level, at a fixed level, we have the level at a certain level, at a fixed level, at a fixed depth, the liquid pressure is same. And as the depth increases, the liquid pressure keeps on increasing. Fine. Now what I'll do is I'll remove these two manometers and I'll check what is the effect of density on the liquid pressure. So I can see that at 1 meter I have the manometer reading as 108.390 kilopascal, right? So here the density is what density of water is taken, and it is 1000 kg per meter cube. Okay, what I'll do is I'll change the fluid to honey from water. See, the density has increased and so has the reading on my manometer scale, right? Now let me decrease the density. So for gasoline, I have the density as 700 kg per meter cube. So I can see that the reading on the manometer has also decreased. Thus, I can say that density is directly proportional to the pressure. As the density increases, the liquid pressure also increases. And as the density decreases, the liquid pressure also decreases, right? Now I'll go back to water and check out what's my pressure at the boundaries. Is any pressure? Do you think the pressure is exerted on the walls of the container? So see, as I go down, I can see that there is a certain amount of pressure which is seen on the walls of this container. So I can say that liquid exerts pressure in all directions, and it also exerts pressure on the walls of the container in which it is, right? You can see, and as I'm going down, as the depth is increasing, so is my liquid pressure, right? Now let's quickly check out one more. So as you can see that the area of both of these devices, both of the containers are different, right? So what I'll do is I'll place my manometer here at 1 meter. So I'll put it exactly there and I'll again see. So this I am doing now, I have to put it. Oh, see, it's same. So at a certain depth, the pressure, it is same. The liquid pressure, it is same irrespective of the size or the shape of the container. So we can have random shaped containers. Let us check quickly this one as well. See, at 1 meter, I have the same liquid pressure. So I can conclude 4-5 factors from this. Let's quickly go back to our presentation to conclude about the liquid pressure. So here there is a container and there are three openings. Let's say this is A, the next one is, this one is B, and the last is C. So obviously, as I can see, C has more depth to it as compared to A. So what do you conclude about liquid pressure? Now here I can see that the water is coming out and it comes to this point. From B, it has covered more distance, and from C, it has covered much more distance. So I can say that the liquid pressure at C is greater. Now this can also be related to depth. So as the depth increases, my liquid pressure also increases, right? Now why do I say that, you know, why is the liquid pressure increasing? See, at A, the particles that are, you know, applying the force is this one, these many. At B, these are the particles from the top till the mid. These are the particles which apply the force. And at C, these are the particles which are applying the force. So obviously, since I already know the formula for pressure, which is pressure is equal to force divided by area, and that means that that can conclude that pressure is directly proportional to the force, right? So at C, since the number of particles are more, so the force that is applied, it is much greater, and hence the liquid pressure will be much, much more at point C as compared to point A. So I can conclude about liquid pressure that liquid pressure increases with the increase in depth, right? Next. So a certain level has been marked with the red line, this red line, and the manometer has been placed. So see, the manometer is at different level of the same line. Now it asked me, what do you conclude about the liquid pressure? So I can see that the reading on the manometer, it is same. See, the pointer is pointing in the same direction, so the magnitude is same. Hence, I can conclude that liquid exerts equal pressure at the same depth. So even if I have placed two more manometers here, still the reading would have been same. Similarly, if I would have placed it here, so it's not a straight line that I've drawn, but yeah, if I had placed a manometer here, the reading would be different, but since the depth has increased, so the manometer reading for the liquid pressure will be more. I hope this part is clear. Next, what do you conclude about the liquid pressure from this? So see, this is a flask, and in that there are various openings. There are four openings there. A person is exerting a force from top. So what I'll see is that water will come out from these openings, right? And from this, I can conclude that liquid exerts pressure in all directions. And we have seen this in the simulation as well, right? Now, for this activity, what you can do is you can take a balloon, fill it with water, and just punch a few holes in it. So as soon as you punch a few holes in it, you will see that water comes out from each and every hole, right? So that means that the water which is there inside the balloon, it will exert force in all the direction and the water will come out, right? Now, next I have this in which there is, in one beaker there is water. And in the other one, there is a cooking oil, right? So the density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Now, earlier in the simulation, I have seen 100,000, right? So it was because the units were in meter. Okay, the units were different. There were SI units there. It was kg per meter cube. That is why it was 1,000. Now here, the cooking oil has the density of 0.93 grams per centimeter cube. So my water has greater density, as I can see from the measurement. And I can also see that the liquid pressure is more in water. The distance that is covered by water is more as compared to the distance that is covered by the cooking oil. So I can say that as the density increases, my liquid pressure will increase. Let's quickly see what we can summarize. So we can conclude that liquid pressure depends on the density of the liquid. I hope all these points are clear. Now there was one more, which was area and the shape. So see, there are different shaped containers here and the water level is same. Now here, if I would have placed a manometer at this particular level, which is the top level of the water, I would have seen that it would have the same measurements, same recording. That would be because liquid pressure does not depend on the shape or the size of the container. So at a particular, like if I would, this is not a straight line. Now if I would have taken this line, then the reading would have been same. So at a particular depth, the liquid pressure, the manometer reading is same. And as the depth increases, my liquid pressure keeps on increasing. I hope all of this is clear to you. Let's see what we have concluded so far. So it is that liquid exerts pressure in all directions, the balloon experiment. It exerts pressure, equal pressure at same depth. When the manometer was placed at a certain depth, it showed the same reading. The liquid pressure increases with increase in depth. So as the depth kept on increasing, I could see that the pressure reading on the manometer was increasing continuously, right? Liquid pressure depends on the density of liquid. So as the density increases, my liquid pressure also increases. So I saw that honey has greater density. So it has, you know, greater pressure. Gasoline had less density than water. So obviously the pressure was low as compared to water. And similarly for oil, for cooking oil, the density was less. So liquid pressure was less as compared to water. I hope this part is clear to you. Next, liquid pressure does not depend on the shape or the size of the container. And lastly, liquid pressure does not depend on the area of surface. So even if you have such a small beaker or such a large beaker, the pressure would be same at the same depth of both the containers. Now let's quickly apply all of these properties that we have just discussed and give reason as to why these things are done the way they are done, right? So first one is that thick walls are there in submarines. Now we all know submarines are used in deep sea oceans and everywhere. So what happens is that submarines, they go down. So as they go down, the liquid pressure will increase because liquid pressure increases with the increase in depth, right? So as the pressure increases and the depth will continuously increase, I could see that obviously the pressure applied would be more. So to sustain that high pressure, we need to have thick walls. Right? Blood transfusion. So you must have seen that, you know, the bottle that transfuses the blood, it's placed at a greater height. Why is it so? It is so because, you know, the water, it flows there, it has high pressure. So the water will be able to go into your veins easily. If the water is kept at a lower base, it will have a low pressure and obviously it will not be able to go into your veins. Right? So at higher level, it has higher pressure, the liquid pressure is high, and the force with which the water will come out will be greater. Now the dams, they have thick walls at the base as compared to at the top where they have thin walls. This is because at the base we have high pressure, and to maintain that high pressure, we have thick walls because we know that as our depth increases, the liquid pressure also increases continuously. Right? Next, you must have seen that the public water supply system, they have like the water tank is on the top of the building. So I have the water tower at the top, then at the house also we have the water tank at the top, and in this building also the water tank is at top. Because at the top the pressure is high and the water will flow from high pressure to low pressure, and since it will, you know, you need the water in the tap, so it will come and be there in your water tank. But if the water tank was placed at the base, at the bottom of the house, the height will not be there, and that is why the pressure will be very low, and that is the reason why, you know, if you need to fill your tankers, you need to have a generator. So the pump or the generator, it moves the water up into the water tank, and you can use this water without using any pump or generator to for your domestic purpose and all the purposes. Now let's quickly summarize what we have just learned. So first is that liquid pressure, now the pressure exerted, it is the pressure which is exerted by the liquid. It depends on the density of the fluid and the height of the container, right? And it does not depend on the size or the shape of the container as well as area of the container, right? Few of the properties are that liquid exerts pressure in all direction, liquid exerts equal pressure at same depth, and liquid pressure increases with the increase in depth. You can see that water is coming from all directions, so liquid exerts pressure in all directions, and at a certain depth the pressure with which the water will come out will be same. And in the third one, obviously we know if we have a beaker and we put out three holes there, the water which will come out will have the highest liquid pressure at the base, then the middle one, and then the top one. Yes. Great. So I hope the topic is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please write in the comment section. Do like our video. Do subscribe to our channel. The next video will be of atmospheric pressure. Hope to see you soon. So till the next video comes out, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye.